welcome. This is Helaluddin Ahmed, and this video will explain you two different costing approach in management accounting. One is variable costing and another is absorption costing. This video will help the students to explain how variable costing differs from absorption costing and compute unit product cost under each method. And this also helps the student to prepare income statements using both variable and absorption costing. Students can also reconcile variable costing and absorption costing operating incomes and explain why the two amounts differ. And finally, they can explain the advantages and disadvantages of both variable and absorption costing. Variable and absorption are two different costing methods. Almost all successful companies in the world use both the methods. Variable costing and absorption costing cannot be substituted for one another because both the system have their own benefits and limitations. These costing approaches are known by various names. For example, variable costing is also known as direct costing or marginal costing, and absorption costing is also known as full costing or traditional costing. The information provided by variable costing method is mostly used by internal management for decision-making purposes. Absorption costing provides information that is used by internal management as well as by external parties like creditors, government agencies and auditors, etc. Under absorption costing system, the product cost consists of all variable as well as all fixed manufacturing cost. For example, direct materials, direct labor, factory overhead. But when variable costing system is used, the fixed cost is treated as a period or capacity cost and is therefore not included in the product cost. Let's go for an example. Harvey company produces a single product and they provided some information regarding their production system. And their number of units produced annually is 25,000. And under variable cost per unit, the direct materials, direct labor and variable manufacturing overhead per unit cost $10 and selling and administrative expense per unit $3. And fixed cost per year, manufacturing overhead in total 150,000 and selling and administrative expense $100,000. Now, unit product cost is determined like this, where under absorption costing, unit product cost is $16 and under variable costing, unit product cost is $10. Here, one thing you should remember, selling and administrative expense are always treated as period expenses and deducted from revenue as incurred. Let's assume the additional information for Harvey company, like 20,000 units were sold during the year at a price of $30 each and there were no units in beginning inventory. Now, let's compute net operating income under both absorption and variable costing. In this calculation, net operating income $120,000 is calculated under absorption costing and the cost of goods manufactured 25,000 units multiplied by $16 per unit and the ending inventory 5,000 units is multiplied by $16 per unit, which was calculated under the absorption costing method. And here one thing you can see that there is no fixed manufacturing overhead. Under the variable costing method, $90,000 of net operating income is calculated using this costing method. And the cost of goods manufactured of 25,000 units was multiplied by $10 per unit, which was calculated under variable manufacturing costing method, and also the ending inventory also, which was $5,000 units was multiplied by $10 per unit. And here you can see that there is a manufacturing overhead that is $150,000. This was the all manufacturing overhead expenses. That is the main differences of variable costing and absorption costing. Now let's compare these two income under absorption costing and variable costing. Here you can see that there is a cost of goods sold is $120,000 under absorption costing, and that was fixed manufacturing cost, and there is an ending inventory under fixed manufacturing cost is $30,000, and there is no period expenses. But under variable costing, there is fixed manufacturing cost $150,000, but there is no fixed manufacturing cost under cost of goods sold and ending inventory. This is the basic differences between absorption and variable costing. Now let's reconcile this concept of differences between variable costing and absorption costing. If we add the fixed manufacturing overhead cost that is deferred in inventory, that is $30,000 in our example, with variable costing net operating income $90,000, we will get the absorption costing net operating income, that is $120,000. If the production of a company is greater than the sales, the overall inventory will increase and the income from absorption costing will be greater than the income from the variable costing. On the other hand, if the production is less than the sales, the inventory will be decreased and the income from absorption costing will be lesser than the income from the variable costing. And if production and sales is equal, there will be no change on the effect on inventory, and also there is no change in the income from absorption costing and variable costing. If we think the impact of the absorption costing and the variable costing on the management system, the different opponents of absorption costing argue that shifting fixed manufacturing overhead cost between periods can lead to many misinterpretation and faulty decisions. Those who favor variable costing argue that the income statements are easier to understand because net operating income is only affected by changes in unit sales. The resulting income amounts are more consistent with manager expectations. However, absorption costing does not support CVP analysis because it essentially treats fixed manufacturing overhead as a variable cost by assigning a per unit amount of the fixed overhead to each unit of production. We will discuss the CVP, that is cost volume profit analysis, in our later chapter or later discussion. And treating fixed manufacturing overhead as a variable cost can lead to faulty pricing decisions and keep or drop decisions. Produce positive net operating income even with the number of units sold is less than the break-even point. There are some advantages of variable costing and the contribution approach. Management finds it more useful in taking their decisions, and this is consistent with CVP analysis. And net operating income is closer to net cash flow if the organization uses variable costing, and also consistent with standard cost and flexible budgeting. And it is easier to estimate profitability to product and segments. Profit is not affected by changes in inventories. Impact of fixed cost on profit emphasized. So what is the final verdict about these differences between variable costing and absorption costing? Fixed manufacturing cost must be assigned to producers to properly match revenue and cost if the organization uses absorption costing. But under variable costing, fixed manufacturing costs are capacity cost and will be incurred even if nothing is produced. And that's all for now. Thank you.